I think we'd be remiss not to tell people exactly what Masada is. And I'll start with the very minimal knowledge I have. And since it's fresh in your mind, you can tell me where I'm wrong and then expand on it. During the siege in 70 against the temple, if I'm not mistaken, right around that time, people were fleeing, and there was a group that went up to the top of this ridge, which in the picture you can see in there. And the nice thing about this fortress is that it is a fortress because you have a 360-degree view all the way around you of whatever may be coming for a very long way, and it's impossible to get up there. So they hiked up there, they got on top, and they had enough supplies. They stayed in there for 2 or so years, and while that happened, the Romans decided
had
that
already they destroyed the temple. Yeah,
they had already destroyed the temple, and they were trying to get this fortress to come down, or the people in this fortress to come down. And they had some very cruel tactics. They were catapulting family members into the walls and whatnot to try to get the people to come out. The people wouldn't come out. So it took them 2 years to build this ramp up to Masada. And I believe that's actually...
I think it was quicker than that. But in any event, they slowly built... And that was on the other side. So that was okay. on the west side of the mountain. They're slowly building that ramp up.
So they finally build the ramp up. They burn the outer wall to and the way that this works is in these sieges, they would burn the outer wall, and then they'd collapse the wall in, and they'd be able to get up and over. Well, as they're burning the wall, the people on the inside, or so the story goes, the people on the inside decided that they'd rather die than be taken captive. They supposedly selected several people, and those people went around and did the deed of exterminating all these people, and then in the end took their own lives. And apparently there were several people who survived. Josephus claims to have been there, or at least he tells the story.
He saw it from a distance. He never. I don't know if he ever was there, but he did interview people who were there and tells the story.
So anyway, so let's go back now that we've kind of, and would you like to expand at all on what I just said in terms of the story? Is there any details?
It's important. Well, you could say that Herod the Great fortified it 100 years prior, almost. And so he had it as as his own getaway. And yeah, they had agriculture growing up there. He had a water supply. They had a real brilliant system for capturing the water from the flash floods in the spring. And so they had water, they had agriculture, they kept pigeons, so they had pigeon meat. And they could pretty much live, you know.
And as you can see from this second picture here, the one with the sun rising that Rob's already talked to us about, if you can imagine, this actually does a 360 view. So basically, you can see for, I mean, miles and miles away in every direction. So if an army is coming to attack you, this is why Masada is such a great fortress. If an army is coming to attack you, you can see them from miles away. There's no surprise ambush.
So, and Rome knew they couldn't take it by the snake path because Herod had a big storage of big stones, boulders. They would just crush the people, who were trying to climb up. And so Rome, they built a siege all the way around on the surrounding hills and kind of cliffs, and then they slowly built this ramp. Crazy.
Hey, did you enjoy that video? If you did, you should like it and share it. That way other people can see it too. And you should subscribe to our YouTube channel. That way you'll never miss another clip. You can do that by clicking this round thing right here. Yeah. Click that right there. Subscribe. It's a good idea.